Most babies are accidents. Not me. I was engineered. Born to save my sister's life.
Hello, my name is Bailey Fritz.
Hi, my name is Alyssa Garcia.
And today we're doing a movieology on My Sister's Keeper. My Sister's Keeper was directed by Nick Cassavet and produced by Stefan Furst. It was released in 2009 and has a running time of 1 hour and 49 minutes. It is rated PG-13 and is a drama-packed film and a box office hit. Let's get into it.
Abigail Breslin, who plays Anna Fitzgerald, is the daughter of Sarah Fitzgerald, who is played by Cameron Diaz. Anna was conceived by in vitro fertilization to save her sister's life as a savior sister. Kate's doctor, Dr. Chance, suggests to use Anna as the perfect genetic match for her older sister, Kate, to donate compatible organs, blood, and tissue in order to keep her sister alive, who is suffering from leukemia.
Hey, baby, what's your son?
Cancer.
You're a cancer?
No, I'm Malia, but I have cancer.
That's not true.
My sister has leukemia. She's been in renal failure for months now. I wouldn't even be alive if Kate wasn't sick. I'm a designer, maybe. I was made in a dish to be spare parts for Kate.
You're kidding, right?
Throughout Anna's young adulthood, her parents put her under these painful treatments such as bone marrow transplants and blood withdrawals without her willingness to do so.
It's my body. I want to be able to make my own decisions about what to do with it.
Once Anna turns 13, her sister's cancer becomes worse and she has kidney failure. Anna knows that she will now be forced by her parents to donate one of her kidneys to her sister. But she realizes that she may not be able to live the life she wants to live without a kidney. When really, the truth is that her sister wants to die and does not want to go through any more treatments. Anna then lies and tells her parents that it is her choice to precede them for medical emancipation and the rights to her own body.
I want to see my parents for the rights to my own body.
Would you repeat that, please?
I want to see my parents for the rights to my own body.
You do know what will happen if you don't give your sister your kidney, don't you?
Yeah, she'll die.
Mom and Dad are gonna kill me. What am I supposed to tell them?
Tell them you're important, too. Tell them you want to play soccer. Tell them you want to cheerlead.
Anna, you're suing us?
I don't want to do it anymore, Mom. It's my body. I want to be able to make my...
Anna's father is always on her side throughout the movie, but her mother, Sarah, thinks that Anna should be willing to save her sister's life with her kidney, so she leads a campaign to keep Kate alive, but she still receives the notice of court proceedings that her daughter gave her.
Because Anna isn't the only person in this equation. And if we were looking at it only from Anna's situation, sure, it is brutal. I mean, who wants to be stuck and poked and prodded by needles?
Attorney Alexander agrees to work for Anna as her guardian, suing for a partial termination of parental rights. Both Sarah and Alexander tell their side of the story to the judge, whom had recently lost her own daughter to cancer, something Sarah slightly mentions. Behind the scenes, Kate's illness has affected not only her siblings' life and their relationships, but also her parents' marriage.
What I don't understand is why you didn't say something earlier.
When, Dad? When should I talk to you about it? You're never home! You leave me here with her!
Excuse me?
I'm important too, Mom! I'm important too!
My disease is killing me, but it's killing my family too.
You've been walking around like nothing's wrong while your sister rots in that hospital.
I just don't want to do it anymore, okay?
Guess what? I don't believe it.
Kate also meets a fellow cancer patient, Taylor Ambrose, who she begins dating. He soon dies and Kate has all this depression and tries to commit suicide, but fails. After a while, Kate has to be hospitalized and has a week left to live at the hospital. She requests to go to the beach, but her mom once again flips out and her husband threatens to divorce.
She's coming out of the hospital!
We're gonna go to the beach.
You take her to the beach, you're killing her! She's gonna die!
You better come, because if you don't, I want a divorce.
As the trials continue, Anna and her mother Sarah go back and forth about why Anna should have the rights to her body and the rights to not give her sister her kidney. Finally, Anna admits the reason she does not want to give Kate her kidney is because Kate wants no more treatments and wants to die and be in.
I don't believe you.
You are hiding something, Anna.
Just tell him. Anna. Tell him why we're here.
You
what are we doing here
me
in court? Tell him, Anna.
Do
God,
this.
You people are so stupid.
You promised.
Kate wants to
Stop
die.
It.
Before Kate dies, her whole family meets at the hospital, and she has a deep moment with her mother, giving her a scrapbook that she made while she was in the hospital over the years, and she dies by her mother's side. At the end of the story, Anna wins the case, and they go to Montana in memory of Kate every year on her birthday.
Worldview breakdown! Woo! For starters, the characters in this movie go against a Christian worldview with their word choice. They use God's name in vain, as well as other cuss words.
Okay, no, you start telling me the truth.
I am telling you the
You're
truth.
You're not, because if you are, I don't know you.
Jesus Christ, Anna, just tell him.
Anna opens the film by saying a lot of unborn babies aren't wanted, but she was.
When I was a kid, my mother told me that I was a little piece of blue sky that came into this world because she and Dad loved me so much. Was I? Most babies are coincidences. I mean, up in space you got all these souls flying around looking for bodies to live in. Then down here on Earth, two people have sex or whatever, and bam, coincidence. Sure, you hear all these stories about how everyone plans these perfect families. But the truth is that most babies are products of drunken evenings and lack of birth control. They're accidents. Only people who have trouble making babies actually plan for them. I, on the other hand, am not a coincidence. I was engineered, born for a particular reason. A scientist hooked up my mother's eggs and my father's sperm to make a specific combination of genes. He did it to save my sister's life.
This movie deals with ethical issues surrounding family planning options such as in vitro fertilization, genetic selection of children, and using those tools to create life with the intention of using it to create other life. This is all playing God. In conclusion, this movie has a nihilistic worldview tone and a humanistic worldview. The characters in the story think that there is no ultimate meaning of life or death, and the characters are silent about the issues of God or any form of theology of heaven or hell.